Hi, I'm Saverio from HoRNet Plugins. Today we are going to show you how you can use our plugins for mastering purpose. We are gonna master one of the track I produced some time ago. It's an electronic track that needs some cleanup in the low, in the mid-low frequencies and some more punch in the mid-highs. And we are gonna use our ChannelStrip MK3 to show you that can also be used for mastering purpose. Our track utility, we are gonna use the stereo wideness control to widen up the track a little bit, and the Magnus limiter to take the track to the highest possible level. Now, let's first take the ChannelStrip MK3 and put it before our spectrum analyzer. We don't want to use its analog characteristic, because in mastering we want everything to be more polished as possible, so we turn off saturation and hiss, but we turn on HQ processing, deactivate its oversampling, and gives us the best processing mode possible in this plugin. First, we'll gain stage the track to have it sit at about +3 on the voometer. So I'm gonna put my headphones on and let's have a listen to the track. Okay, here's the unfinished track. You probably heard that it has a little bit of congestion in the mid-lows, and it's not defined in the mid-highs. It's a little bit scooped probably there. We are gonna use first our Dynamics 1 processor to tighten up the sound and reduce the amount of lows, of wows in the lows. And then the EQ to bring up a little bit more of the mid-highs and fix some problems in the mid-lows. So, for the compressor we are gonna use the Opto model, because it's the smoothest model we have and it's perfect for this kind of duties. And we are aiming for 2 or 3 dB of gain reduction. Okay. Just this processor tightens up a little bit the sound. Let's listen how it sounds with and without. As you heard, we gained a little bit of more presence and we controlled a little bit the resonance in the lows. Now we're gonna apply the EQ, because if you have a look here to the spectrum analyzer, you can see that we have some strange resonance in around 200 Hz, and it's probably the bass, because it's a very deep bass sound in this song. Look here. This is around 200 Hz, and we are gonna use our first parametric equalizer here and put it around 200 Hz with a nice and very straight Q, and we'll find the right frequency using the gain. Okay, we're almost there. Now that we found this frequency, we are gonna cut it off using the gain parameter, and at about -4 probably. We'll have a listen later with a wider Q, so we catch all, even the surrounding frequencies. Okay, if I remove the EQ, you'll now hear the frequencies back. It already sounds a little bit more clean. Now we're gonna, with our high pass filter, we are gonna cut everything below 40 Hz because we are not gonna hear it anyway. So we are cleaning up the track for the limiter stage. And now we are gonna make some general adjustment to bring up the mid highs and have a little bit more definition at around 3000 Hz with a wide Q. We'll add a couple of dBs here. Gained a little bit more definition, and now we're gonna bring up the kick because it's a soft kick and we want to have a little bit more punch. So at around 60 Hz we are gonna apply 3 dBs and it should bring out the kick a little bit more. You're probably hearing that it already sounds very well. It's an improved version. This EQ drastically changed everything in the track. We're not going to use Dynamics 2, so I can turn it off. And we are leaving the output gain as it is. And we're going to the next stage. The next stage, we are going to use our track utility to widen up a little bit the sound, and we're gonna make sure that no peak exceeds minus 6 dBs. So first we'll widen up a little bit the track using the width control. Okay, track got a little bit more higher, it has a little bit more expensive sound. And now, using the auto gain facility in the HoRNet track utility, we are gonna make sure that no peaks exceed minus 6 dBs. So turn on the auto gain, minus 6 here, and let it play so that we can make sure that it adjusts its gain 10 again. Okay, he calculates the gain and then we can turn off the auto gain, and now we are sure that we are hitting the limiter stage with the perfect sound. For the limiter, we are going to use our Magnus plugin. It's a two-stage limiter. The first is a clipper and the second is the limiter. And for the clipper, we are using the soft clip algorithm, because we are gonna round off every straight corner so that the limiter works less and it's, we can compress more without obvious artifacts. So we are aiming for some clip here, as indicated by the meta, and then we are gonna aim for 3 dBs of gain reduction in the limiter, maybe 4, we'll have a listen. But over the overall RMS level must sit at around minus 10. We are not going to use oversample, and we're going to use the auto release that works perfectly fine by its own. So let's have a listen to how we can make the track sound louder. you probably have seen, we hit minus 9.9 dBs, that is perfectly fine for our mastering duty, and the limiter sounds quite transparent still. So here is how you can master tracks using our HoRNet plugins, and you can find all the plugins we use in this brief tutorial on www.hornetplugins.com. Go there, we provide the demo for everything you heard here, so you can try out for yourself, have a listen, let us know what you think about it, and thank you for watching.